as he feeds off the energy of the other competitors. First, he gobbles up the Hero lead. Now he becomes the leader of a bizarre triathlon water ballet. When you spend an 8-hour day swimming, biking, and running, eating and drinking are key to success. Welch has an early brunch and then stores a snack for later. Alan and the others give chase, slowing slightly as the turnaround in Javi approaches. The bike leg takes more than 4.5 hours, and halfway through it, the race has fallen into a predictable pattern of changing leaders among an elite trio of Welch, Alan, and Kiyuru. Welch takes on food and fuel and prepares for the long haul back to town. Alan, the Zen master, is guided by his own race plan and the beep of his heart monitor. He maintains a steady, patient rhythm. Dissatisfied with the pace of the race, Kiyuru passes Alan and takes off after Welch. Once again relegated to second place, Welch is left to consider just what he has to do to remain in front. Meanwhile, the comfort of the ruling clique is broken by the arrival of a South American interloper, Christian Bustos. And while Kiyuru continues to lead, Bustos, who owns a sheep farm outside of Santiago, Chile, makes an astounding move. Only ninth last year and known primarily as a good runner, he's improved dramatically on the bike. Now he startles his more famous and accomplished opponents by zipping by them. Alan lost to Bustos in Chile early in the year and must wonder if that is an omen of what is to come today. Welch now has someone new to worry about. Finally, even Kiyuru senses that something is up and turns to look. Bustos, who not long ago had to sell his sheep just to buy a plane ticket to a race, is suddenly a serious threat. And Alan treats him like one. In a move that seems to signal desperation, he slingshots past Welch and then Bustos and heads off after the leader, Kiyuru. The complexion of the race has changed with the arrival of Bustos, making the race's outcome even more uncertain.
Alan has more on his mind than just the tenacious Bustos. There's more trouble behind, and it's only too real. The chief rival and main threat remains Welch, the effervescent and literal opposite of Alan's focused demeanor. But if opposites do attract, the triathlon world is in for more collisions at the top. Welch represents the new breed of triathlete. His style may be a bit different than all the others, but maybe that's the way Greg lives his life.
Hey, go and have a beer with your mates every now and again. Go and hang down the beach and have a surf. Don't forget the things where you have fun. Because if you do and become too serious, I think you lose it.
In 1989, he astonished the triathlon world with a third-place finish. So right from the beginning, Welch has had unusual success in the most grueling race of all. A remarkable feat, considering it usually takes years to learn the intricacies of the race. Maybe the secret lies in his training techniques.
Don't try and go to the pub and drink 20 beers with your mates when you know you can't and get carried out on a stretcher. Been there, done that. I can only handle 10. Now that I'm an athlete, I can only handle about 6.
Welch spends half the year in his homeland of Australia, and the other half in what is considered the triathlete mecca of the world, Southern California. And competing and living among his peers, he thinks, has given him an extra edge.
I think that a lot of the people in this sport are too serious, and being happy-go-lucky and just sort of having a smile on the face all the time is pretty personable. It's good for sponsors, it's good for me, it's good for the sport.
How can this happy-go-lucky California lifestyle coincide with the rugged training of a triathlete? Sure, Welch puts in the miles, but does his carefree demeanor and flamboyant personality offset a serious training regimen?
You know, a lot of people have said to me, well, if you'd be focused and, you know, got a little bit more serious about it, you would go as far as saying to me that you'd be pretty much unbeatable. Nah, that'd be stupid, you know. And then I sat down and thought about it and I thought, well, yeah, possible, but at the same time, you know, it's always good to sort of like have a streak of like about 4 or 5 wins or something like that, and then to get your butt kicked and get back into gear.
The only thing separating Welch from greatness is Mark Allen, who beat him last year. But despite the growing rivalry, there remains a deep respect.
I wouldn't have even budged about standing in line for his autograph. Serious. And I still idolize the guy. You know, Mark, that is. I still idolize him. I think he's unbelievable. He's a work of art. Like, you just have to look at him. He's a hard worker. He's focused. And, you know, I just think that he's got one disadvantage, you know, in the sport. And, you know, but that's fine. I mean, everything else is good about him. The disadvantage for him, unfortunately, is me.
Welch isn't all hype either. Right now, the freest spirit in the field has Allen and more than 1,000 triathletes chasing him. The Gatorade Ironman Triathlon will return in a moment. Just off the shores of the Big Island, the women's competition is more than 40 miles into the bike ride. A 27-year-old Wendy Ingram still has the lead. A triathlete for 6 years, she still hasn't been able to make enough money on the circuit to become a full-time pro. And on her heels now is the consummate pro. Paula Newby Fraser has closed the gap dramatically, and the inevitable is about to happen. Time champion glides by with confident precision, as if Ingram doesn't even exist. No acknowledgement here. This is Newbie Fraser's race, and she's taken it back. There's no woman in the field whose resume even begins to approach Newbie Fraser's, and her race has come into clear focus. Up ahead, the men's is about to take yet another turn.
The leaders have established a comfortable rhythm when suddenly a new German arrives, anxious to leave his mark on the race, Jürgen Zach. Zach, a 3-time German champion, won the grueling Zofingen Duathlon earlier this year, beating, among others, Mark Allen. Now he shows the pain of his come-from-behind effort. He's made up an amazing 5-minute deficit on the bike. And as he moves up alongside Allen, Zach looks at the 3-time Gatorade Ironman champion, probing for weakness. And to announce his arrival,